The following program deals with controversial subjects, and due to its explicit nature, parental guidance is strongly advised. The theories, opinions, and beliefs expressed are not the only possible interpretations. The viewer is invited to make a judgment based on all available information. Most people agree that evil exists in this world. For some, it's war, famine, or violence. For some, it's a spiritual darkness. And for others, evil is a very real presence, a physical entity of terrifying power. What is evil? Is it merely a dictionary definition, morally wrong or bad? Or is it something more, a deeper, darker force that makes people perform cruel and inhuman acts? Does an evil force really exist that can attract and then control the actions of human beings? Or is evil nothing more than a convenient excuse for deviant and destructive behavior? These are questions without easy answers and are continually debated by those who study the human mind and the human spirit.
Everywhere in the world we've seen cruelty and things that are vicious and things that are anti-human, and that somehow that's the kind of the opposite of the affirmation of life.
The great mass of human misery is caused not by some evil force, but by the stupid beliefs and actions that we engage in.
A human being has power in this world to do what he or she wants, and if what you want to do is evil, you can do terrible things. We have to decide to be good or evil. No one else makes that decision.
We're exposed to evil every day. Robbery, kidnapping, even murder have become tragically commonplace on the evening news. We've become anesthetized to the evil around us.
But then there is evil that will never be trivialized in media. Hitler, architect of Nazism and the mastermind of the Holocaust. Stalin, butcher 40 million. Cult leader Jim Jones, who led 900 into mass suicide. Jeffrey Dahmer and Charles Manson. What drives people like these to the depths of evil?